Very good morning. My name is Jan Robert Schutte, Crypto Academy, with a daily crypto vision of Monday, 23rd of March. This is second week in the quarantine, and we are now in the office still, and it's freezing. That's why I've got a scarf, not because of Corona. We see the market under pressure again, whereas the BTC dominance is standing at 65%. That means that Bitcoin is a little bit outperforming the general crypto market. Bitcoin, of course, number one with a market of $106 billion, almost 8% lower. Ethereum, 122.83 trading, minus 8.4%, and Ripple also meager $0.15 with a market of $6.5 billion, also 6% lower. Bitcoin Satoshi Vision actually also more than 10% lower. That's a very severe down trend for the short term. We've seen some news about Ripple, and on Cointelegraph it is reported that Intermex is not using Ripple for its Mexican remittances. In its March earnings call, US Latin American remittances provider Intermex revealed that it will not be using Ripple XRP's technology. In its major markets, Intermex chief executive Robert Lisf explains. So you won't really see us leveraging Ripple in our core markets. I think it will bring us more growth in newer markets and places where we are exploring going into ancillary products, unquote. Intermex is to use Ripple for ancillary products in newer markets. And Ripple announced its partnership with Intermex on February 5 with its press release emphasizing that the deal would enable faster cross-border payments between the US and Mexico. And despite its claim, Intermex CEO asserted Ripple will not be an answer for places like Mexico. We are very proud of the relationship we have there. And Intermex has recently sought to expand its presence in Africa, suggesting that it is likely the market where the payments company will employ Ripple's technology, so not in Mexico. And Intermex is not Ripple's only partner to reveal aspects of its partnership that likely have been poorly received by XRP holders. In a recent interview, a representative of a US-based payment firm MoneyGram revealed that the firm liquidates all XRP received through its partnership as soon as tokens are received. And during 2019, MoneyGram sold $11.3 million worth of XRP, increasing the monthly sell pressure on the XRP market by $1 million. And Ripple announced its partnership with MoneyGram in January 2018, with the deal intended to increase settlement speeds and bolster liquidity on the payments platform. MoneyGram began using Ripple's technology in August 2019. And per the filing with the US Securities and Exchange Commission, SEC, MoneyGram is compensated by Ripple in XRP for developing and bringing liquidity to foreign exchange markets, facilitated by the ODL platform and providing a reliable level of foreign exchange trading activity. In November 2019, so last year, MoneyGram estimated 10% of the Mexican peso volume is executed by using Ripple's on-demand liquidity platform. So that's no surprise why Ripple is under pressure all the time. So that's not a good sign. However, for our HODL portfolio, we added some coins yesterday, and also for our dollar cost averaging portfolio. Here we see the weekly chart of Bitcoin with a spike down towards 4K, now trading around 5,800 with a spike towards 7 in last week, and now it's trading within a narrow trading range. And if I zoom into the daily crypto daily chart of Bitcoin US dollar on a trading view, then we see a consolidating pattern: 7k to the upside, 5000 to the downside, 2000 trading range, and I'm waiting for an impetus to the upside. I'm long, still long, and here it is on the 4-hourly basis. There has been generated a long signal around 6,100, now a little bit under pressure. Whereas the stop loss is on a 4-hourly basis on 5,345. So I see a lot of upside potential. 7K, 8K for the short term. And if you would like to see more information about our crypto markets and our daily crypto visions, go to cryptoacademy.nl and of course to our Facebook and other social media channels. Hasta la vista.